Victims of sexual assault are getting justice in the civil courts. Hello, this is Larry Bodine, editor-in-chief of personalinjury.com, and today we're speaking with attorney Stephen Sweat. Stephen, how are you today?
Good, Larry. How are you doing?
Doing well. Stephen is a personal injury attorney in Los Angeles who represents many victims of sexual attacks. What can the civil justice system do for individuals who have been subject to an attack that the criminal justice system can't do?
Well, you have to understand that there are two different burdens of proof between the civil system and the criminal system. In the criminal justice system, you have to prove that someone's guilty beyond a reasonable doubt, which is a fairly high standard. In the civil justice system, it's basically in most jurisdictions a preponderance of the evidence, which is much lower. The benefit to sexual assault victims is many times where the assailant is not criminally convicted, it doesn't necessarily mean that the victim cannot try to get a monetary award through the civil justice system.
I understand you represent a number of victims of sexual assault. Give me the fact pattern that you find common in these sorts of cases.
Well, it's unfortunate. It's an ugly scenario, but what I'm seeing crop up time and time again recently is that of patients in hospitals or mental health facilities or nursing homes that are being sexually assaulted by employees of those facilities, such as nurses and orderlies, and even doctors sometimes.
Even doctors, that's really shocking.
It is, and it's pretty rare that it would happen, but it does happen.
And I understand that in some of the cases you're handling, the attackers have committed these assaults more than once. Why does that happen?
Well, in particular, what I'm seeing is in mental health facilities, people are brought in, obviously, with mental health issues, and therefore they are not believed when they state that they've been sexually assaulted by an employee. I had a case recently where there were four prior incidents, allegations of sexual assault by a particular nurse in a mental health hospital, and it took to incident number five, which was my client, to finally have the hospital wake up and investigate this. The nurse was criminally convicted for multiple felony charges, and I was able to obtain a seven-figure recovery for the client.
Why do hospitals and nursing homes, ignore the backgrounds of these people who are clearly dangerous?
In general, it's a problem with sexual assault cases where the victim is not believed. We don't want to, unfortunately, think that these things can happen. And we certainly don't want to think that it can happen on, quote unquote, my watch.
Stephen, where can people find out more about remedies that victims of sexual abuse can have? And if somebody wants to get in touch with you, how can they do that?
Well, I actually have a whole blog only on sexual abuse and assault topics. It's victimslawyercalifornia.blogspot.com. And then I also have quite a few blogs and pages and other information on my main website, which is victimslawyer.com.
Well, we've been talking with Stephen Sweat, a personal injury attorney in Los Angeles, about how victims of sexual assault can get justice in the civil courts. Stephen, I want to thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, Larry.